decided to call Alicia Rumble. Jamie's old friend from school. Darcy rummaged through the phone book and found her number. Hi, Alicia. This is Darcy, Jamie Will's sister. Listen, was there a fight at school today? A fight? I didn't see any fight. I was in the library during free period, and I just don't know about any fight, Alicia said. Jamie said she fell. Darcy went to Jamie's room and rapped on the door. Go away, Jamie yelled. Jamie, you gotta talk to me or I'm calling Mom, Darcy said. After a few seconds, Jamie opened the door. What do you want? Haven't you done enough? You messed it up for me and Bobby. Now we're just gonna rub it in my face. Just leave me alone. Did Bobby Wallace hit you? Darcy demanded. Darcy, I'm warning you. You'll only make things worse. Somebody could get hurt. Jamie turned and slammed the door in Darcy's face. Darcy felt sick. As long as Jamie denied that Bobby hit her, there was nothing Darcy could do. But it made Darcy furious to think Bobby outworked his rage on her little sister. Darcy while one of the officers came toward Darcy's apartment. silver Toyota. Yes, who is that man? What does he want? He's been at my school and everywhere I've been. Why is he stalking me? Darcy adds with increasing agitation. He claims to be your father, miss. The officer replied calmly. All this time I know it was her raggedy ass father. Darcy's heart pounded wildly. She gasped as if she was choking. My father? No, it can't be. My father has been in New York for years. He said his name is Carl Wells, and his ID checks out. He has no outstanding warrants. He said he has two daughters, a 14-year-old and a 16-year-old, that hasn't been seen in 5 years.
5 years.
I asked him to tell me what your birth date is. He said you were born April 6th. Is that correct? Yes, but anybody could know that. Darcy's damn right. Miss, I'm going to ask my partner to have the man step from the car and walk under the street lamp. You should be able to see pretty well from here. Enough to know if it could be your father, the officer said. But I haven't seen him in 5 years, Darcy said. Just take a good look, the officer said. Is your mother home? No, she's at work. There's nobody here but my sister and my grandma. And my grandma's sick, Darcy answered. All right, as the officer said, just take it easy. Darcy watched the heavy man get out the car again. He shuffled to the corner under the bright street light. Darcy remembered her father sprinting across a field after a baseball as fast as a teenager. It couldn't be him, she told herself. Her father took such pride in his body and keeping fit. He used to work out at the gym and brag about wearing that same clothes size he did as a teenager. My daddy got fat and then he got old, Darcy remembered her father saying with a sharp laugh. I'm not going that route, no way. Now the man was standing directly under the light. For a moment, he reminded Darcy of a pathetic baggy pants, two-bit clown caught in the footlights of a cheap theater. The man removed his baseball cap, revealing short gray hair, like a stiff bristle, a stubby dead grass at the end of the summer. Darcy's father has black hair, as black as shiny surface, a black Mercedes dreamed of and never got. Dad's skin was smooth and just right plump. This man was pouchy faced like a balloon, but most of the air leaked out. He had dark circles under his eyes. His whole body sagged like partially full garbage bag